talking to you twice, I think, maybe three. So every time it's in your benefit, even now, the videos that me and you did together, they've gone now and reached up to 100,000. So clearly, money is your motivation. And that's cool. But nigga, don't pretend like we was cool. Don't pretend like it was like that. You sitting here calling a young lady, first of all, I'm not married. You call a young lady a B word, and you claim it's not for all black women, but a 71-year-old man, which is her father, a Muslim brother, got to hear you calling his daughter a B, and that never said a word to you. Never said a goddamn word to you. And you, it's like, I got a lot of calls about you for real. They say you do this all the time because you jealous of celebrities. You might want to make us seem like we ain't shit, but you are afraid of a celebrity coming into the YouTube world. So you keep fake little receipts on them. So if they come into your so-called world, and if they don't shout you out and make you seem like you the best motherfucker, then somehow these receipts will show up and you'll pretend like they was cool. When you tried to say that, oh, why you showing me your girl? Nigga, you showed me your new son. Did you forget about that, nigga? Like, I'm confused on how you try to make another man look weak when you 47 years old having new babies by the same people that you calling ain't shit. So which one is it, nigga? They ain't shit and you gonna pay them and fuck them and then keep paying them having babies? Like, which one is it, nigga? Like, I don't understand, nigga. That was some corny shit that you trying to make up. You jumped the gun. You are an emotional little punk. And that's why you over here talking the way you talking. Because I didn't say nothing to you. And nigga, it ain't about no integrity when we never broke bread together. So all that shit you try, see, you the worst type of nigga. A nigga that got a little hood side and a little small little education and know how to trick niggas and say words that make niggas hold on to what they saying. Yeah, my nigga, you supposed to do what you say you gonna do. You supposed to do what you say you gonna do. Which one is it? Is this the streets or is this business? Cause I don't gotta do what I say I'm gonna do. I said we could do an interview when I got time, motherfucker. And I said maybe you can get on Judge Joe. But I said hell no, cause Judge Joe did a motherfucking million views. And that's why your bitch ass mad. You can go look up videos all you want to. You can go goddamn talk about somebody pass away that can't speak about the situation. You bring that up cause it fits your narrative. But five people, that's a lie. That said something that you can go talk to, your bitch ass won't go and say nothing about them. You can't go email these people that you can converse with, honey. So that shit don't make no sense. A lot of you rappers are hanging around niggas like that and like that bitch ass nigga. I ain't even gonna say your name, bitch boy, but a nigga that try to steal clout.
Like I said before, I've been at it for seven months from the time that I seen when he disrespect George Floyd, when he disrespect Gabby from Empower, when he disrespect Kanika, when he disrespect the other, what's her name, Brianna. It's countless people that he disrespect every fucking day. Tommy does it every fucking day. When it was that little girl, Bass, it was a girl that was there, a woman that was there, and they talked about and clowned about. She didn't have on a bra. And then he talked about the living arrangements, how the complex was nasty and this and that and the other. And that was around the first time I started making videos. And it wasn't about no damn clout or trolling. I just don't like with this nigga spilling hate speech, calling women bees and stuff like that. Calling them H's and other things and saying that F the black community, all of them need to die. He hopes a new Holocaust, so all of them can make it another Holocaust, so they can take all the black people and kill all of them. And then he goes on and he was talking about this girl named Sugar Shade Room or whatever. He done the same thing. But now, y'all want to sit there and pretend like you know it now. But you didn't know it then. But this guy right here is actually speaking on it. And I'm glad for that. Because you know what? He got a big enough page now that he can sit Tommy ass the fuck down. Because people are tired of his ass. You know, before I was saying, no, he don't need to be off the internet. But yeah, you know, he needs to. It have been 6 months strong and he is still going and going and going. He talked about this little girl that committed suicide. She have been molested. She have been abused and stuff like that. And the first thing he said, because she stayed in the trailer, and that's the reason why she killed herself, because she couldn't live in filth anymore. There's another one, a black woman. She had lost her daughter to DSS. And what happened was she got abused, and the young black girl hung herself. Now, she hung herself. And he was saying, oh, it's the mother's fault that her daughter's dead because of the simple fact that if it wasn't for her losing custody or doing drugs or whatever she was doing to lose custody, that her daughter wouldn't be dead. And then he was saying black bees and stuff like that. She's only out for money and stuff. Since he deleted a lot of his videos, it's probably hard to find any right now, so I can go by word of what everything he said. But I wouldn't want to go on his damn thing. There's plenty of other videos out there that's not under his damn thing. But it's stuff like that. He speak of the dead like they are trash. He speak of the dead like he does. First of all, he did say something bad about DMX. He said, and he tried to say basically that DMX was probably a pedophile. So yeah, he did say something bad. For him to sit there and say that, that's fucked up. DMX was doing it at a what? He was doing it. Music is entertainment. Now, DMX, every one of his songs, he had something about God in it, stuff like that. Majority of his albums, he talked about that. So, I don't understand how people like Tommy can get on here and say what the hell he want, and nobody else, I ain't see nothing and nobody said nothing. But, you know, I like when people like this guy right here, Brown, Mr. Brown, how he talked about come. And I'm like, what is up with this nigga? Why is he always sitting there down on? It was a white woman that came on his show. I guess she had a black husband, and she was getting on him about something. He called her all types of bees, and then he muted her so she couldn't talk. He said, "What you say, bee?" And then he fucking put her back on there after he called her all types of trash names and stuff like that, and he'll unpause her, and he'll pause her back again, and he'll unpause her, and he'll keep saying foul stuff to her. And then he'll hang up on her and say and call her all types of whores and stuff like that. So I'm like, that's what he do. And you telling me that it's some educated women on there that wear wigs and defend him? Get out of here with that. What, y'all in love with him? What are y'all getting out of it? You must be getting paid or something. And then he have his friends. Well, either they do it on their own. Well, I don't think they do it on their own, because they have to be following my page or following all these other people's pages or something like that. And it is what, automatically go? He probably tell them. That's all that is. Because he get more money when it's more drama. He gets more money when it's more drama. But I'm not doing it for the drama. I'm not doing it for no trolling. I'm just like this. When I first watched him when was that? It been some good years ago. And see, my daughter, she's 5. She was a baby. She's like 1. 4 years ago. 4 years ago, I stopped watching him. Because it was this incident where it was 2. What made me like, okay, man. It was like this guy. No, it was a young boy. I think he was a teenager. And, you know, he went up to a woman and said she had a fat ass or whatever. He smacked on her ass. She went to her car and she shot the guy. Shot the young boy several times. And he said, see, if he wasn't listening to rap music and this and that and the other and stuff like that, that's why he died. He deserved it. That's somebody's child. For him to say something like that, that's just messed up. Now, it was another situation. It was a woman her family, her ex-boyfriend or somebody, she broke up with the guy, he was violent or whatever the case may be, and he shot her several times or stabbed her one, stabbed her one or something like that. So what he did is, you know, he said he's a crime channel. He was a report the news. The little bit of news he reported wasn't even a lot. Trey King. I think it's Trey King. Trey King show? He talks about all these subjects. Yeah, but he don't sit there and say the stuff he do. He can see you. It's a way you can do it. But Tommy, he don't want to do it that way. Because I guess he feel the only way he can do it, unless he got drama going on, that's the only way somebody gonna watch him or whatever. So since he's not gonna do it, yeah, now I believe he need to be off YouTube. Just completely off. They kick Shane Dawson off, so they can kick his ass off. He's just as rude. He's just as speaking. He was painting his face black and pretending he was a black person, and then talking about how much he don't like them and stuff like that, how they dirty and stuff like that. Tommy said some of the same stuff. So why is it different that Tommy did it from what Dawson did? It's the same thing, regardless if it's a black guy or white guy. Are Chinese or Vietnamese, and it don't matter what freaking color they are. It's wrong altogether. Now, with saying that, I say bravo to this guy that I have up there. Bravo to him. And I like the fact that he is talking about building his community, helping people, helping kids. And unfortunately, what I said to Tommy in the other video, when he was talking about that little girl, Bass, and how her family looked, and then how this other... Anyways, I said to him in a video that if he have a problem about how the community is suffering, he have a big platform. He could have started a fund. He could have spoke to some kids, try to tell them, look, don't go that way, don't do drugs or whatever the case may be, the little fuck nigga want to do. Calm down. Speak without curse words. Or whatever the case he wanted to do. And if he wanted to speak on, oh, it's women going around and they get all these marathons and stuff like this. They get marathons and they get all this money. But they don't do that for men. Okay, so now you want to talk about women get breast awareness funds and stuff like that. Okay, you're a man. Instead of arguing about it, instead of whimping and crying about it, why don't you do something? You have a big fucking platform. You could have done it by now. That's 4 years you have been whining about the same shit. About the women get this and the women get that. But you talk down to the women, and most of the women you talk down to is the ones that you already slept with. So, whatever. Yeah, I heard the video saying you got 30 thoughts on how you don't wash your ass. So, anyways, that's hearsay because I don't know if it's true. And I really don't care about that part. But my point is, and I just seen this other video, Face Your Truth. And this shit was like some years ago. Face Your Truth. And he said what he don't like about black women is their hair stink and the room stinks when you have sex with them. What the hell? Well, he probably just sleeps with nasty women that don't wash their ass. My fucking hair don't stink when I wear wigs. So maybe they don't wash their hair. Hey, if he likes them like that, that's his opinion. That's him. It's not his opinion when he based that on all black women. That is not his opinion on one woman. It's his opinion on the whole race. And he said, fuck the black community. So why are y'all still following him? So y'all want to be white too, just like Tommy, right? Is that what it is? Y'all want to be white too? Y'all want to go to that movie like the Get Out and get your brain part taken out and put into a white person? Is that what it is? No, I don't think that should happen. And even if y'all attempt to do that, y'all even try to bleach your skin or whatever, I hope it just, you to get darker. Because that'll be your punishment from God to look darker and darker. And you will never be able to look white, even if you tried to bleach your skin, Tommy. That Jesus just cursed you with that. He's disrespectful. He have a 2 girls, I think he said, in that video. Don't know how many he have now. But he got 2 brown-skinned, probably beautiful girls. And hopefully they don't take after him. And hopefully they don't see none of these. But also, hey. He said that some dude was trolling his daughter. But when you talk about all women like that, that can happen. When you do stuff like that, your people could get trolled. The real life shit. That's how angry you make people. I'm not going to do no shit like that. I just say to you what I want to say. Without going on your show so you don't meet me. And no, I'm not an angry black woman. Nope. I just don't like for people to go out there and say the stuff that he says. That's the difference. So don't even bother saying no bullshit. It's just people like this harmful. Yeah, also, it's this boy called the Red Pill. The Red Pill God or some shit. Wow. He looked like he's about what? 15, 16? Look like he's not over the age of 18. And if he is, he's still young. So that means he could be 18, 19. But I don't even think he's that old. So with that being said, what age did he start watching Tommy and start talking crap about black women? Which he have a black mama and she should wash his mouth out with soap. Everyone gets on him about the same thing. He don't change for nothing. He can't stay off talking about nobody, crap about nobody, because no one likes him. Who knows? They're probably not even troll. They're probably his 100 damn pages. Because nobody likes him. He want to harass this dude for the same reason. Because anyone, I have said this too, anyone that gets fucking hired him with YouTubes, friends only, fucking celebrities, or anything, he will bash them. But he'll pick the one or two that no one's gonna fucking talk about. Like Gabby. All he said about Gabby and her husband was unnecessary. Unnecessary. It made no darn sense. And I believe he was the one that started that crap for them to start picking on her about her weight and shit. What the fuck? Nigga, you ain't that damn fucking skinny yourself. That bush on your fucking thing. What the heck? That looks nasty. Shape it up. You can't keep that shit shaped up. The heck is your problem? Something serious is wrong with you. And I said, you need to get your head checked with your bended issues from your mama probably beat your ass. Shoot, she probably had a reason. But obviously, you didn't learn the Bible lesson about that. So you getting your butt spanked. You probably deserved it. For you, when you was a kid. For when you get older. Just say it like this. When a child get older. Okay, if their parents done this and done that or whatever. Forgive them. Move the hell on. Seek therapy. Don't get on the internet and pretend like a damn internet thug, which you're not. And go around and try to bully people, the ones you think is weak. Bully them to get them off the internet or whatever the case may be you do. Which is true because you do it all the time. You harass people. So I don't understand why you're still on here. They need to go ahead and boot you on off the fucking damn world. You fucking Satan need to come up from fucking hell and fucking take his pitchfork and drag it through your goddamn chest and drag your ass to hell. Like the movie Drag Me to Hell. They definitely need to drag your ass there. I done told you, I'm never going to stop. Not until they do something to your ass to make you stop and make you act right. No one's going to stop. And I want no one to stop. Don't make threats. Don't do none of that shit. You just fucking, hey, you can't. You find out what the hell he says. You know what? Fucking do that. Because you know what? Until he's done with this, stop acting like a big ass baby, whining and crying about every damn thing. His mouth need to be washed out. I done said that. His mama should have fucking washed his mouth out with soap. His foul mouth. And he a preacher's shoe. He got on there talking about how she got all types of bees and stuff like that. I'm like, what the heck? You talk to your mama with that damn mouth? And anyone that knows him, any woman that knows him, a man that don't respect his mama, no matter what the fuck she did to him in the past, and forgave her or whatever for it, they ain't saying they had to deal with her, but I'm saying, if they ain't forgiven their own soul, and they say all that stuff like that, it's something wrong with him. You might want to keep on walking, because that means he got a lot of anger issues in his head, he probably have voices in his head too, and he got two or three or four different goddamn personalities. He got abandonment father issues. When that movie, he said, I pay my child support with it. Call that woman all types of things. I pay my child support with it. Oh, I'm a coon. I'm gonna love being a coon. I don't like y'all black niggas. I'm like, what the hell? Something wrong with him. That motherfucker needs psychological help. And half of his damn followers do too. They need psychological help too. All y'all need psychological help. Because something is not right in y'all head either. Well, y'all sit there and get on there and say all that stuff like that. You fucking take people videos. You put it on there. And you talk pretty crap about them. And where they can't even fucking respond back to you. Because it's their video. And you're recording their video from theirs. Oh, like that one girl, she was on there. You was texting her, recording her video, and talking pretty crap to her. Yeah. So I don't see why even they make anybody take the pictures or videos down on your ass. Because you do the same fucking thing to other people that they do to you. So it should be no different. None at all. Oh, excuse me. None at all, Tommy. It should be no difference because you do the same thing time and time again. What are you going to do? You going to cry? You going to cry? Yeah, cry, Tommy. Cry. Because your soul ain't right. Your head ain't right. Your face ain't right. You just look jacked the hell up. Go get all that fixed up. Because you got psychological problems and you need help. And yes, and when a person do sexualized stuff, what happens with that is, matter of fact, I had a homegirl, just a point, a great fucking exact thing what I'm talking about. Now, I had a associate. I went over to her house, her godmother, I think it was, had a boyfriend, and me and her was there, and another homegirl of mine's, and he just did something weird. Like, first, my two associates, the one that knew him, he sprayed something on her chest or something. She had like a tank top on, and then he went up and sniffed it. And I'm like, and then he did the other girl. I backed up like, I don't know you like that. Now, obviously, he been doing it for a long period of time, because when that is not normal, no fucking grown-ass man spray no perfume in somebody on their chest, and wish he didn't have no boots down, because he was like fucking 12 and 13 and 14. And for him to just sniff it like that, and I try to tell her, that nigga ain't right. Something is not right with him. He act like he could be a pedophile. Or a rapist. And what do you know? He tried to rape the girl's fucking mother. So my senses on things are very high. So that stunt with that towel, you calling your daughter and she's laying on the couch and you said, look at this. And first she said you just got out of the shower. And when she turned around, she seen you open your towel. She said, ew. And you put it on repeat. So obviously she's used to you doing that. Next video upload, I will have the definition of desensitizing a person and for when they pedophile, and it's called grooming. So I have them two according where the definition of it, and then I will continue to probably have another talk about Tommy or something else, but I will have it. So stay tuned to that. YouTube, y'all stay safe. Watch out for the coronavirus. Thumbs up, like, please, no messed up comments, because everything I'm saying is facts. By his psychological help, is facts. Because therapists, when a person have abandoned issues, they act out. They like a lot of attention. And when they don't get that attention, they throw a tantrum. What happens when they grow up and they never resolve the issues? They act out. So they hate everyone like them. So his mama was black. His daddy was black. Who did he say he hate? Black women. He gets and talks about a lot of black men. So what did that say? Oh, yeah, he was on the show one particular time, and he said, shit, y'all motherfuckers ain't my fathers. Y'all pay me. But y'all still follow him, though. That's why I say you're sick in the head. He said, you motherfuckers ain't my damn friends. They pay me to watch, to listen to me talk. They pay him to listen to him talk. These are not my damn friends. What do that say? He said it loud and clear for you to fucking hear. He repeated the damn shit that was on his podcast. So someone captured it and posted it. So yay for that person. Yay for every person to get him in his contradictions for when he sit there and try to make up something or try to cover up something. Guess what? It's a person that got a video of it somewhere. And whenever he says something and someone trying to defend him, then you need to post another video stating what he said. And YouTube should allow them to do it. Why? Because it's proving that they're not lying. That is own facts. Not a lie. It's my opinion about he got a psychological help. He got abandonment issues. He got issues with black people because his parents are black and he have a problem with them. So, that's something he said himself. Again, him talking about his daughter in the shower. Taking it in the shower with him, and she was looking. You know, while she start, I stopped talking to his baby mama and asked and talking to her about why he stopped taking a shower with his daughter. That she was funneling with her breasts. About 19 years old. 19 years old, probably 12 or 11, is when the boobs start to go in. So with that being said, she was old enough to know she was getting breasts. She was old enough to notice daddy have different parts than she do. That's called a little too fucking old to be sitting there in a shower with your daddy. That's nasty. That's nasty and sick. Pedophiles do that shit. He do pedophile jokes. He do fucking crazy shit all the damn time. And Mike put on a mask to look like Michael Jackson and dancing and saying that he was picking at somebody else? Disrespecting Michael Jackson? What the hell? What is wrong with this dude? What is wrong with this dude? Something is serious wrong with him. Psychological help. He needs it. But his fans won't tell him that. Y'all just that's boosting his head up when y'all know he needs psychological help. I don't care for fucking drama, but I speak on things when I feel people are being wrong, when I feel he's picking on or talking crap about a whole fucking community. So if he's saying all blacks or whatever, that clues me too. So therefore, that's why I'm saying what I'm saying. I'm defending my fucking self. Why? Because, yeah, I grew up in a fucking hood in, but I wasn't no hoe. I was babysitting my nephews and cousins, and their people was in their jobs. They was at their jobs. They were not whoring on the street or any of that. They say a whole community, it takes a whole community to raise a child, and it's fucking true. It takes a whole community. So even if a father's not there, it don't fucking matter, because it's other people in the family will help. But in his case, he's over, what, 44, 45 now? The psychological help he need might not help him. Because he's 40-something fucking years old. He passed 40, actually. So, with that being said, good night. Y'all have a nice night. Like and subscribe. So you can hit that what the heck? Notification bell. Y'all have a great morning, because it's about to be morning.
talking to you twice, I think, maybe three. So every time it's in your benefit. Even now, the videos that me and you did together, they've gone now and reached up to 100,000. So clearly, money is your motivation. And that's cool. But nigga, don't pretend like we was cool. Don't pretend like it was like that. You sitting here calling a young lady. First of all, I'm not married. You call a young lady a B word, and you claim it's not for all black women. But a 71-year-old man, which is her father, a Muslim brother, got to hear you calling his daughter a B. And that never said a word to you. Never said a goddamn word to you. And you, it's like, I got a lot of calls about you for real. They say you do this all the time because you jealous of celebrities. You might want to make us seem like we ain't shit, but you are afraid of a celebrity coming into the YouTube world. So you keep fake little receipts on them. So if they come into your so-called world, and if they don't shout you out and make you seem like you the best motherfucker, then somehow these receipts will show up and you'll pretend like they was cool. When you tried to say that, oh, why you showing me your girl? Nigga, you showed me your new son. Did you forget about that, nigga? Like, I'm confused on how you try to make another man look weak when you 47 years old having new babies by the same people that you calling ain't shit. So which one is it, nigga? They ain't shit and you gonna pay them and fuck them and then keep paying them having babies? Like, which one is it, nigga? Like, I don't understand, nigga. That was some corny shit that you trying to make up. You jumped the gun. You are an emotional little punk. And that's why you over here talking the way you talking. Because I didn't say nothing to you. And, nigga, it ain't about no integrity when we never broke bread together. So all that shit you trying... See, you the worst type of nigga. A nigga that got a little hood side and a little small little education and know how to trick niggas and say words that make niggas hold on to what they saying. Yeah, my nigga, you supposed to do what you say you gonna do. You supposed to do what you say you gonna do. Which one is it? Is this the streets or is this business? Because I don't got to do what I say I'm gonna do. I said we could do an interview when I got time, motherfucker. And I said maybe you can get on Judge Joe. But I said hell no, because Judge Joe did a motherfucking million views. And that's why your bitch ass mad. You can go look up videos all you want to. You can go goddamn talk about somebody pass away that can't speak about the situation. You bring that up because it fits your narrative. But five people, that's a lie. That said something that you can go talk to, your bitch at home won't say nothing about them. You can't go email these people that you can converse with, honey. So that shit don't make no sense. A lot of you rappers are hanging around niggas like that, and like that bitch ass nigga, I ain't even gonna say your name, bitch boy, but a nigga that try to steal clout.
Like I said before, I've been at it for 7 months from the time that I seen when he disrespect George Floyd, when he disrespect Gabby from Empower, when he disrespect Kanika, when he disrespect the other, what's her name, Brianna. It's countless people that he disrespect every fucking day. Tommy does it every fucking day. When it was that little girl, Bass, it was a girl that was there, a woman that was there, and they talked about and clowned about. She didn't have on a bra. And then he talked about the living arrangements, how the complex was nasty and this and that and the other. And that was around the first time I started making videos. And it wasn't about no damn clout or trolling. I just don't like with this nigga spilling hate speech, calling women bees and stuff like that, calling them H's and other things, and saying that, F the black community, all of them need to die. He hope it's a new Holocaust, so all of them can make it another Holocaust, so they can take all the black people and kill all of them. And then he goes on and he was talking about this girl named Sugar Shay, Shade Room or whatever. He done the same thing. But now, y'all want to sit there and pretend like you know it now. But you didn't know it then. But this guy right here is actually speaking on it. And I'm glad for that. Because you know what? He got a big enough page now that he can sit Tommy ass the fuck down. Because people are tired of his ass. You know, before I was saying, no, he don't need to be off the internet. But yeah, you know, he needs to. It have been 6 months strong, and he is still going and going and going. He talked about this little girl that committed suicide. She have been molested. She have been molested. She have been abused and stuff like that. And the first thing he say, because she stayed in the trailer, and that's the reason why she killed herself, because she couldn't live in filth anymore. There's another one. A black woman. She had lost her daughter to DSS. And what happened was she got abused and the young black girl hung herself. Now, she hung herself. And he was saying, oh, it's the mother's fault that her daughter's dead because of the simple fact that if it wasn't for her losing custody or doing drugs or whatever she was doing to lose custody, that her daughter wouldn't be dead. And that's then he was saying black bees and stuff like that. She's only out for money and stuff. Since he deleted a lot of his videos, it's probably hard to find any right now, so I can go by word of what everything he said. But I wouldn't want to go on his damn thing. There's plenty of other videos out there that's not under his damn thing. But it's stuff like that. He speak of the dead like they are trash. He speak of the dead like he does. First of all, he did say something bad about DMX. He said, and he tried to say basically that DMX was probably a pedophile. So yeah, he did say something bad. For him to sit there and say that, that's fucked up. DMX was doing it at a what? He was doing it. Music is entertainment. Now, DMX, every one of his songs, he had something about God in it, stuff like that. Majority of his albums, he talked about that. So, I don't understand how people like Tommy can get on here and say what the hell he want, and nobody else, I ain't see nothing and nobody said nothing. But, you know, I like when people like this guy right here, Brown, Mr. Brown, how he talked about come, and I'm like, what is up with this nigga? Why is he always sitting there down on? It was a white woman that came on his show. I guess she had a black husband, and she was getting on him about something. He called her all types of bees, and then he muted her. So she couldn't talk. He said, what you say, B? And then he fucking put her back on there after he say that. Said, call her all types of trash names and stuff like that. And he'll unpause her. And he'll pause her back again. And he'll unpause her. And he'll keep saying foul stuff to her. And then he'll hang up on her and say, and call her all types of whores and stuff like that. So I'm like that. That's what he do. And you telling me that it's some educated women on there that wear wigs and defend him? Get out of here with that. What, y'all in love with him? What are y'all getting out of it? You must be getting paid or something. And then he have his friends. Well, either they do it on their own. Well, I don't think they do it on their own because they have to be following my page or following all these other people's pages or something like that. And it is what, automatically go? He probably tell them. That's all that is. Because he get more money when it's more drama. He gets more money when it's more drama. But I'm not doing it for the drama. I'm not doing it for no trolling. I'm just like this. When I first watched him about, when was that? It been some good years ago. And see, my daughter, she's 5. She was a baby. She's like 1. 4 years ago. 4 years ago, I stopped watching him because it was this incident where it was 2. What made me like, okay, man. It was like this guy. No, it was a young boy. I think he was a teenager. And, you know, he went up to a woman and said she had a fat ass or whatever. He smacked on her ass. She went to her car and she shot the guy. Shot the young boy several times. And he said, see, if he wasn't listening to rap music and this and that and other and stuff like that, that's why he died. He deserved it. That's somebody's child. For him to say something like that, that's just messed up. Now, it was another situation. It was a woman. Her family, her ex-boyfriend or somebody, she broke up with the guy. He was violent or whatever the case may be. And he shot her several times or stabbed her one. Stabbed her one or something like that. So, what he did is, you know, he said he's a crime channel. He was a report the news. The little bit of news he reported wasn't even a lot. Trey King. I think it's Trey King. Trey King show? He talks about all these subjects. Yeah, but he don't sit there and say the stuff he do. It's a way you can do it. But Tommy, he don't want to do it that way. Because I guess he feel the only way he can do it, unless he got drama going on, that's the only way somebody gonna watch him or whatever. So since he's not gonna do it, yeah, now I believe he need to be off YouTube. Just completely off. They kicked Shane Dawson off, so they can kick his ass off. He's just as rude. He's just as speaking. He was painting his face black and pretending he was a black person, and then talking about how much he don't like them and stuff like that, how they dirty and stuff like that. Tommy said some of the same stuff. So why is it different that Tommy did it from what Dawson did? It's the same thing, regardless if it's a black guy or white guy. Are Chinese or Vietnamese, and don't matter what freaking color they are. It's wrong altogether. Now, with saying that, I say bravo to this guy that I have up there. Bravo to him. And I like the fact that he is talking about building his community, helping people, helping kids. And unfortunately, what I said to Tommy in the other video when he was talking about that little girl, Bass, and how her family looked, and then how this other... Anyways, I said to him in a video that if he have a problem about how the community is suffering, he have a big platform. He could have started a fund. He could have spoke to some kids, try to tell them, look, don't go that way, don't do drugs or whatever the case may be the little fuck nigga want to do. Calm down. Speak without curse words. Or whatever the case he wanted to do. And if he wanted to speak on, it's women going around and they get all these marathons and stuff like this. They get marathons and they get all this money. But they don't do that for men. Okay, so now you want to talk about women get breast awareness funds and stuff like that. Okay, you're a man. Instead of arguing about it, instead of whimping and crying about it, why don't you do something? You have a big fucking platform. You could have done it by now. That's 4 years you have been whining about the same shit. About young, about the women get this and the women get that. But you talk down to the women, and most of the women you talk down to is the ones that you already slept with. So, whatever. Yeah, I heard the video saying you got 30 slots and how you don't wash your ass. So, anyways, that's hearsay because I don't know if it's true, and I really don't care about that part. But my point is, and I just seen this other video, Face Your Truth. And this shit was like some years ago. Face Your Truth. And he said what he don't like about black women is their hair stink and their room stinks when you have sex with them. What the hell? Well, he probably just sleeps with nasty women that don't wash their ass. My fucking hair don't stink when I wear wigs. So maybe they don't wash their hair. Hey, if he likes them like that, that's his opinion. That's him. It's not his opinion when he based that on all black women. That is not his opinion on one woman. It's his opinion on the whole race. And he said, fuck the black community. So why are y'all still following him? So y'all want to be white too, just like Tommy, right? Is that what it is? Y'all want to be white too? Y'all want to go to that movie like the Get Out and get your brain part taken out and put into a white person? Is that what it is? No, I don't think that should happen. And even if y'all attempt to do that, to even try to bleach your skin or whatever, I hope it just, you to get darker. Because that'll be your punishment from God to look darker and darker. And you will never be able to look white, even if you try to bleach your skin, Tommy. That Jesus just cursed you with that. He's disrespectful. He have two girls, I think he said, in that video. Don't know how many he have now. But he got two brown-skinned, probably beautiful girls, and hopefully they don't take after him. And hopefully they don't see none of these. But also, hey. He said that some dude was trolling his daughter. But when you talk about all women like that, that can happen. When you do stuff like that, your people could get trolled. The real life shit. That's how angry you make people. I'm not going to do no shit like that. I just say to you what I want to say. Without going on your show so you don't meet me. And no, I'm not an angry black woman. Nope. I just don't like for people to go out there and say the stuff that he says. That's the difference. So don't even bother saying no bullshit. It's just people like this harmful. Yeah, also, it's this boy called the Red Pill. The Red Pill God or some shit. Wow. He looked like he's about what? 15, 16? Look like he's not over the age of 18. And if he is, he's still young. So that means he could be 18, 19. But I don't even think he's that old. So with that being said, what age did he start watching Tommy and start talking crap about black women? Which he have a black mama and she should wash his mouth out with soap. Everyone gets on him about the same thing. He don't change for nothing. He can't stay off talking about nobody, crap about nobody, because no one likes him. Who knows? They're probably not even troll. They're probably his 100 damn pages. Because nobody likes him. He want to harass this dude for the same reason. Because anyone, I have said this too, anyone that gets fucking hired him with YouTubes, friends only, fucking celebrities, or anything, he will bash them. But he'll pick the one or two that no one's gonna fucking talk about. Like Gabby. All he said about Gabby and her husband was unnecessary. Unnecessary. It made no darn sense. And I believe he was the one that started that crap for them to start picking on her about her weight and shit. What the fuck? Nigga, you ain't that damn fucking skinny yourself. That bush on your fucking thing. What the heck? That looks nasty. Shape it up. You can't keep that shit shaped up. The heck is your problem? Something serious is wrong with you. I done said you need to get your head checked with your abandoned issues from your mama probably beat your ass. Shoot, she probably had a reason. But obviously she didn't learn the Bible lesson about that. So you getting your butt spanked, you probably deserved it. For you, when you was a kid. For when you get older, just say it like this. When a child get older, okay, if their parents done this and done that or whatever, forgive them, move the hell on, seek therapy. Don't get on the internet and pretend like a damn internet thug, which you're not. And go around and try to bully people, the ones you think is weak. Bully them to get them off the internet or whatever the case may be you do. Which is true because you do it all the time. You harass people. So I don't understand why you're still on here. They need to go ahead and boot you on off the fucking damn world. You can fucking Satan need to come up from fucking hell and fucking take his pitch for and drag it through your goddamn chest and drag your ass to hell. Like the movie Drag Me to Hell. They definitely need to drag your ass there. I done told you, I'm never going to stop. Not until they do something to your ass to make you stop and make you act right. No one's going to stop. And I want no one to stop. Don't make threats. Don't do none of that shit. You just fucking, hey, you can't. You find out what the hell he says. You know what? Fucking do that. Because you know what? Until he's done with this, stop acting like a big ass baby, whining and crying about every damn thing. His mouth need to be washed out. I done said that. His mama should have fucking washed his mouth out with soap. His foul mouth. And he a preacher's shoe. He got on there talking about how she got all types of bees and stuff like that. I'm like, what the heck? You talk to your mama with that damn mouth? And anyone that knows him, any woman that knows him, a man that don't respect his mama, no matter what the fuck she did to him in the past, and forgave her or whatever for it, they ain't saying they had to deal with her, but I'm saying, if they ain't forgiving their own soul, and they say all that stuff like that, it's something wrong with him. You might want to keep on walking, because that means he got a lot of anger issues in his head, he probably have voices in his head too, and he had two or three or four different goddamn personalities. He got abandonment father issues. When that movie, he said, I pay my child support with it. Call that woman all types of things. I pay my child support with it. Oh, I'm a coon. I'm gonna love being a coon. I don't like y'all black niggas. I'm like, what the hell? Something wrong with him. That motherfucker needs psychological help. And half of his damn followers do too. They need psychological help too. All y'all need psychological help. Because something is not right in y'all head either. Well, y'all sit there and get on there and say all that stuff like that. You fucking take people videos. You put it on there. And you talk pretty crap about them. And where they can't even fucking respond back to you. Because it's their video. And you're recording their video from theirs. Oh, like that one girl, she was on there. You was texting her, recording her video, and talking pretty crap to her. Yeah. So I don't see why even they make anybody take the pictures or videos down on your ass. Because you do the same fucking thing to other people that they do to you. So it should be no different. None at all. Oh, excuse me. None at all, Tommy. It should be no difference because you do the same thing time and time again. What are you going to do? You going to cry? You going to cry? Yeah, cry, Tommy. Cry. Because your soul ain't right. Your head ain't right. Your face ain't right. You just look jacked the hell up. Go get all that fixed up. Because you got psychological problems and you need help. And yes, and when a person do sexual life stuff, what happens with that is, matter of fact, I had a homegirl, just a point, a great fucking exact thing, what I'm talking about. Now, I had an associate. I went over to her house, her godmother, I think it was, had a boyfriend. And me and her was there, and another homegirl of mine's. And he just did something weird. Like, first, my two associates, the one that knew him, he sprayed something on her chest or something. She had like a tank top on. And then he went up and sniffed it. And I'm like, and then he did the other girl. I backed up like, I don't know you like that. Now, obviously he been doing it for a long period of time, because when that is not normal, no fucking grown ass man spray no perfume in somebody on their chest, and wish she didn't have no boots down, because he was like fucking 12 and 13 and 14. And for him to just sniff it like that, and I try to tell her, that nigga ain't right. Something is not right with him. He act like he could be a pedophile or a rapist. And what do you know? He tried to rape the girl's fucking mother. So my senses on things are very high. So that stunt with that towel, you calling your daughter and she's laying on the couch and you said, look at this. And first she said you just got out of the shower, and when she turned around, she seen you open your towel. She said, ew. And you put it on repeat. So obviously she's used to you doing that. Next video I upload, I will have the definition of desensitizing a person and for when they pedophile, and it's called grooming. So I have them two according where the definition of it. And then I will continue to probably have another talk about Tommy or something else. But I will have it. So stay tuned to that. YouTube, y'all stay safe. Watch out for the coronavirus. Thumbs up, like, please, no messed up comments. Because everything I'm saying is facts. By his psychological help, is facts. Because therapists, when a person have abandoned issues, they act out. They like a lot of attention. And when they don't get that attention, they throw a tantrum. What happens when they grow up and they never resolve the issues? They act out. So they hate everyone like them. So his mom was black. His daddy was black. Who did he say he hate? Black women. He gets and talks about a lot of black men. So what did that say? Oh, yeah. He was on the show one particular time. And he said, shit, y'all motherfuckers ain't my fathers. Y'all pay me. But y'all still follow him, though. That's why I say you're sick in the head. He said, you motherfuckers ain't my damn friends. They pay me to watch, to listen to me talk. They pay him to listen to him talk. These are not my damn friends. What do that say? He said it loud and clear for you to fucking hear. He repeated the damn shit that was on his podcast. So someone captured it and posted it. So yay for that person. Yay for every person to get him in his contradictions for when he sit there and try to make up something or try to cover up something. Guess what? It's a person that got a video of it somewhere. And whenever he says something and someone trying to defend him, then you need to post another video stating what he said. And you two should allow them to do it. Why? Because it's proving that they're not lying. That is own facts. Not a lie. It's my opinion about he got a psychological help. He got abandonment issues. He got issues with black people because his parents are black and he have a problem with them. So that's something he said himself. Again, him talking about his daughter in the shower, taking it in the shower with him, and she was looking. You know, while she start, I stopped talking to his baby mama and asked and talking to her about why he stopped taking a shower with his daughter, that she was funneling with her breasts. About 19 years old, 19 years old, probably 12 or 11, is when the boobs start to go in. So with that being said, she was old enough and knowing she was getting breasts. She was old enough to notice daddy have different parts than she do. That's called a little too fucking old to be sitting there in a shower with your daddy. That's nasty. That's nasty and sick. Pedophiles do that shit. He do pedophile jokes. He do fucking crazy shit all the damn time. And Mike put on a mask to look like Michael Jackson and dancing and saying that he was picking at somebody else. Disrespecting Michael Jackson? What the hell? What is wrong with this dude? What is wrong with this dude? Something is serious wrong with him. Psychological help. He needs it. But his fans won't tell him that. Y'all just... just boosting his head up when y'all know he needs psychological help. I don't care for fucking drama, but I speak on things when I feel people are being wrong, when I feel he's picking on or talking crap about a whole fucking community. So if he's saying all blacks or whatever, that includes me too. So therefore, that's why I'm saying what I'm saying. I'm defending my fucking self. Why? Because, yeah, I grew up in a fucking hood in, but I wasn't no hoe. I was babysitting my nephews and cousins, and their people was in their jobs. They was at their jobs. They were not whoring on the street or any of that. They say it takes a whole community to raise a child, and it's fucking true. It takes a whole community. So even if a father's not there, it don't fucking matter because it's other people in the family will help. But in his case, he's over, 44, 45 now? The psychological help he need might not help him. Because he's 40-something fucking years old. He passed 40, actually. So, with that being said, good night. Y'all have a nice night. Like and subscribe. So you can hit that notification. What the heck? Notification bell. Y'all have a great morning because it's about to be morning.